Hi, welcome to Enchiridion. I am more than happy to share with you these really interesting facts on Sarcosuchus, on a documentary-style program episode of Prehistoric Beasts. Most people have never heard of Sarcosuchus, yet know this creature from the more popular name of Super Croc. This is largely due to the fact that Sarcosuchus is one of the biggest crocodiles ever to live, reaching an average size of 30 feet or 9 meters and 3.5 metric tons or 3.9 short tons, with an upper bound of 31 feet or 9.5 meters long and roughly 4.3 metric tons or 4.7 short tons. Sarcosuchus was a crocodyliform, a distant relative of living crocodilians that lived during the Early Cretaceous from the Late Hauterivian to the Early Albian, 133 to 112 million years ago in what is now South America and Africa. It is known from two species, Sarcosuchus imperator from the Early Albian Elrhaz formation of Niger, and Sarcosuchus hartti from the Late Hauterivian of northeastern Brazil. Another material is known from Morocco and Tunisia, and possibly even Mali and Libya. Initially, Sarcosuchus was only known from associated osteoderms and teeth. In 1964, the first skull was discovered, and the type species could then be established. Nonetheless, it wasn't until the end of the 20th century, when teams led by Paul Sereno recovered more complete remains including ribs, vertebra, and other parts of the postcranial skeleton. This later led to the explosion of Sarcosuchus in popular media, leading it to be featured in numerous documentaries. Although its remains are incomplete, there's now enough material to provide a more accurate estimate on the potential size of this prehistoric beast. During the course of several expeditions on the Sahara, from 1946 to 1959, led by the French paleontologist Albert-Félix, several fossils of a crocodyliform of large size were unearthed in the region known as the Continental Intercalaire Formation. Some of them were found in Fogara Bendrau in Mali, near the town of Alef, Algeria, informally named as the Alef Crocodile, while others came from the Ain El Gouder Formation of Gara Kambudi in the south of Tunisia. The fossils found were fragments of the skull, teeth, scutes, and vertebrae. In 1957, in the region now known as the Elrhaz Formation in the north of Niger, several isolated teeth of great size were found by H. Foray. The study of this material by French paleontologist Franz de Bruyne helped identify them as coming from a new long-snouted crocodile. Later, in 1964, the research team of the French CEA discovered an almost complete skull in the region of Gado Fana in the north of Niger, and said skull was shipped to Paris for study and became the holotype of the then new genus and species Sarcosuchus imperator in 1966. In 1867, American naturalist Charles Hart found two isolated teeth and sent them to the American paleontologist O.C. Marsh, who erected a new species of crocodilus for them, Crocodilus hartti. This material, along with other remains, were assigned in 1907 to the genus Goniophilus as Goniophilus hartti. In 1977, a new species of Sarcosuchus was recognized, Sarcosuchus hartti, from remains found in the late 19th century in late Hauterivian pebbly conglomerates and green shales belonging to the Elrhaz group in the Rancanabo Basin of northeastern Brazil. Now residing in the British Museum of Natural History, the fragment of the lower jaw, dorsal scute, and two teeth comprising the species Goniophilus hartti were re-examined and conclusively placed in the genus Sarcosuchus. The next major findings occurred during the expeditions led by the renowned American paleontologist Paul Sereno in 1995 in the Alfaus Formation in Morocco, 1997, and the follow-up trip in 2000. Partial skeletons, numerous skulls, and 20 tons of assorted other fossils were recovered from the deposits of the Elrhaz Formation, which has been dated as late Aptian or early Albian stages of the late Cretaceous. It took about a year to prepare the Sarcosuchus remains. In 2010, fossils were found in the Ibn Suain formation of Morocco. Fossil teeth from the era of Nalut in northwestern Libya, possibly Hauterivian to Barremian age, might be referable to Sarcosuchus imperator. Indeterminate Sarcosuchus material, including dorsal osteoderms and anatomical connection, isolated teeth and fragmentary skeletal remains including a mandible fragment, a left scapula, dorsal vertebra, a proximal portion of the femur, and ilium was described in the Omed Diab member in Tunisia in 2018. Sarcosuchus was gargantuan compared to crocodiles, with fully grown individuals estimated to have reached up to 29.5 to 31.2 feet, or 9 to 9.5 meters, and weighed 3.5 to 4.3 metric tons, or 3.9 to 4.7 short tons, while other estimates place it at 39 feet or 12 meters long and even heavier. It had somewhat telescoped eyes and a long snout comprising 75% of the length of the skull. There were 35 teeth in each side of the upper jaw, while in the lower jaw there were 31 teeth in each side. The upper jaw was also noticeably longer than the lower one, leaving a gap between them when the jaws were shut, creating an overbite. In young individuals, the shape of the snout resembled that of the living gharial, but in fully grown individuals, it became considerably broader. Sarcosuchus had an expansion at the end of its snout known as a bulla, which has been compared with the gara seen in gharials. Nonetheless, unlike the gara, which is only found in male gharials, the bulla is present in all Sarcosuchus skulls that have been found so far, indicating that it was not a sexually dimorphic trait. The exact purpose of the structure is unknown. The osteoderms, or dermal scutes, of Sarcosuchus were similar to those of goniophilidids, like Goniophilus and Sunosuchus. They formed an uninterrupted surface that began in the posterior part of the neck up to the middle of the tail, like as seen in Ararebesuchus and other primitive crocodyliforms, different from the pattern seen in extant crocodiles, which present discontinuity between the osteoderms of the neck and the body, with sizes ranging a maximum of 16 to 19.5 feet, or 5 to 6 meters, and rare individuals reaching up to 23 feet, or 7 meters in length. Today's crocodiles are simply dwarfed in comparison, with the prehistoric ones being almost twice as large. A common method to estimate the size of crocodiles and crocodile-like reptiles is the use of the length of the skull, measured in the midline from the tip of the snout to the back of the skull table, because in living crocodilians there is a strong correlation between skull length and total body length in subadult and adult individuals irrespective of their sex. And this method was used by Serrano et al. In 2001 for Sarcosuchus due to the absence of a complete enough skeleton. Two regression equations were used to estimate the size of Sarcosuchus imperator. They were created based on measurements gathered from 17 captive gharial individuals from northern India, and from 28 wild saltwater crocodile individuals from northern Australia, with both datasets supplemented by available measurements of the skulls of Sarcosuchus individuals over 4.92 feet or 1.5 meters in length found in the literature. The largest known skull of Sarcosuchus imperator, the type specimen, is 5.25 feet or 1.6 meters long, 4.92 feet or 1.5 meters in the midline, and it was estimated that the individual had a total body length of 38.2 feet, or 11.65 meters. Its snout bend length of 18.7 feet or 5.7 meters was estimated using linear equations from the saltwater crocodile, and in turn this measurement was used to estimate its body size at 8 metric tons, or 8.8 short tons. This shows that Sarcosuchus was able to reach a maximum body size not only greater than previously estimated, but also greater than that of the Miocene Rhamphosuchus, the late Cretaceous Dinosuchus, and the Miocene Purosaurus, according to current estimates at that time. Nonetheless, extrapolation from the femur of a subadult individual, in addition to measurements from the skull width, further showed that the largest Sarcosuchus imperator was significantly smaller than was estimated by Serrano et al. In 2001, based on modern crocodilians. In 2019, O'Brien et al. Estimated the length of the largest Sarcosuchus imperator specimen at 31 feet, or 9.5 meters, and a body weight at 4.3 metric tons or 4.7 short tons, based on Langerostean crocodilian skull width to total length ratio. This estimate is rather close and consistent with the femur-based estimate, which was 29.9 feet or 9.1 meters, so it wasn't as big as it was previously believed to have been. Sarcosuchus was not just bigger than today's crocodiles, but also much older. Most crocodiles have an average lifespan in the wild of roughly 25 years, with some exceptions, as some reach 30 or slightly more. Studying the growth rings present on some of the osteoderms indicate that Sarcosuchus was around 40 years old and yet not fully developed when it died. As opposed to today's crocodiles that grow large and then their growth halts when they reach adulthood, Sarcosuchus kept getting bigger and bigger. Possibly the only limiting factor as to how big it grew was when it could no longer sustain such a massive body with the available food supply, which was what may have dictated its size. Serrano took thin sections from trunk osteoderms of an estimated subadult individual, roughly 80% of estimated adult size. Approximately 40 lines of arrested growth, LAG, were counted in these thin sections, suggesting that Sarcosuchus took 50 to 60 years to reach adult size. Given that extant wild crocodilians rarely reached these advanced stages, Sereno suggested that Sarcosuchus imperator achieved its large size by extending its period of rapid juvenile growth. A similar growth strategy has been suggested for the equally titanic crocodilian Dinosuchus, based on similar criteria. Based on the broader snout of fully grown Sarcosuchus imperator, when compared with the Libyan gharial and other narrow-snouted crocodiles, along with a lack of interlocking of the smooth and sturdy crown teeth when the jaws were closed, Sereno et al. Hypothesized that Sarcosuchus imperator had a generalized diet similar to that of the Nile crocodile, which could have included large terrestrial prey like the ubiquitous dinosaurs that lived in the same region. However, a 2014 analysis of biomechanical model of its skull suggested that unlike Dinosuchus, Sarcosuchus may not have been able to perform the death roll maneuver used by extant crocodilians to dismember their prey. This suggests that if Sarcosuchus imperator did hunt big game, it probably did not dismember prey in the same fashion as extant crocodilians. The remains of Sarcosuchus imperator were found in a region of the Tenerife Desert named Gedufua, more specifically in the Elrhaz formation of the Tagama group, dating from the late Albian to the early Albian of the Early Cretaceous, roughly 112 million years ago. The stratigraphy of the region and the aquatic fauna that was found therein indicates that it was an inland fluvial environment, entirely freshwater in nature, with a humid tropical climate. Sarcosuchus imperator shared the waters with the Halassian fish, Lepidotus, and the coelacanth Mausonia. The dinosaur fauna was represented by the iguanodontian, Lurdosaurus, which was the most common dinosaur in the region, and its relative Oranosaurus. There were also two sauropods, Nigerosaurus, and a currently unnamed sauropod, while the theropod fauna included the Spinosaurid Suchomimus, the Carcharodontosaurid Eocarcharia, and the Abelisaurid Cryptos Palaios. Meanwhile, Sarcosuchus hartti was found in the Recôncavo Basin of Brazil, specifically in the Elrhaz formation of the Bahia series. It was a shallow lacustrine environment dating from the late Albian, similar in age to the habitat of Sarcosuchus imperator, with similar aquatic fauna, including Lepidotus and two species of Mausonia. The dinosaur fauna is of a very fragmentary nature, and identification does not go beyond intermediate theropod and iguanodontid remains. Sarcosuchus means flesh crocodile. It comes from the Greek word sarx meaning flesh and suchus meaning crocodile. Franz de Bruyn and Philip Taquet named the type species in 1966. It belongs to the kingdom Animalia, the phylum Chordata, the class Reptilia, the clade Tethysuchodia, the genus Sarcosuchus, and the type species Sarcosuchus imperator. Sarcosuchus is commonly classified as part of the clade of Phalaenosauridae, a group of crocodyliforms, or crocodile-like reptiles, related but outside Crocodilia, which is the clade containing extant crocodiles, gharials, and alligators. Within this group, it is most closely related to the North American genus, Terminonaris. Most members of Phalaenosauridae have long, slender snouts, and they all were aquatic, inhabiting several different environments. Some forms are interpreted as marine, capable of tolerating salt water, while others, like Sarcosuchus, were freshwater forms. The most primitive members of the clade, however, were found in coastal settings, zones of mixing of freshwater and marine waters. Sarcosuchus stands out among phalaenosaurids for being considered a generalist predator, different from most known members of the clade, which are specialized piscivores. A 2019 study found it to be a more derived position in Tethysuchia, being phylogenetically closer to Dinosauridae. Here is a simplified cladogram after Fortier et al. In 2011. Species include Sarcosuchus imperator, which is a type, and other species like Sarcosuchus hartti. It was a carnivore. As such a massive predator, Sarcosuchus would have had to have focused its attention on hunting animals that could provide enough sustenance to keep its body going, and the two main animal groups available to it were the large lowfin fish and dinosaurs. While the idea of Sarcosuchus shooting out of the water to drag a hadrosaur of the shoreline is a terrifying one, you need to look at the teeth and jaws of Sarcosuchus for clues. Dinosuchus had broad jaws and powerful teeth, perfect for dealing with large and powerful prey that would have been struggling as it dragged it into the water. However, the jaws of Sarcosuchus had proportionally longer and thinner jaws with rather small teeth, more suited to a fish diet. It wasn't until Sarcosuchus grew bigger and older that the jaws began to widen, The tip of the upper jaw was also hooked downwards, another adaptation seen in other fish-eating crocodiles, and providing additional support for this view. It reached an average size of 30 feet, or 9 meters, and 3.5 metric tons, or 3.9 short tons, with an upper bound of 31 feet, or 9.5 meters long, and roughly 4.3 metric tons, or 4.7 short tons. Here is a table of how Sarcosuchus compares with other giant crocodiles, though these are mostly the upper bound estimates of these crocodiles. It has been found in Niger, Africa, and possibly in Brazil. Predatory dinosaurs of the time and locations include Psychomimus and Spinosaurus. Both dinosaurs have long, thin snouts akin to some crocodiles, and their teeth are numerous, pointed, and sharp. This has led to most paleontologists speculating that they were fish hunters, and if true, then there must have been a plentiful supply of fish, of such size and sustenance to keep their numbers and massive bodies going. A large crocodile of similar size but less active lifestyle and possibly slower metabolism would have been even more suited to surviving upon a fish diet than these dinosaurs. It may of course be that Sarcosuchus had different lifestyles and diets at different stages of its life. Fish are easy prey for small crocodiles, but as they grew larger, they would require more sustenance to keep going and survive, and so they may have begun to incorporate dinosaurs into their diets as well. As seen in crocodiles today, they may have also left the water to scavenge the kills of the larger dinosaurs as well. It lived during the Albian to Albian of the Cretaceous, 133 to 112 million years ago. Fossil representation includes many specimens, mainly their teeth and skulls. At the end of the 20th century, parts of the postcranial skeleton were discovered. With most of the Sarcosuchus remains known from Africa, other fossils discovered in Brazil have also been attributed to it. Nonetheless, these specimens may yet prove to be from another ancient crocodile. Crocodyliforms come in all shapes and sizes, from the boar croc to the rat croc, to the dog croc and the super croc, Sarcosuchus, a massive prehistoric beast, a rather old one, and a terrifying sight to behold. Sarcosuchus, immense, powerful, and terrifying. And with that, thank you for watching! When I reach 1,000 subscribers, stay tuned for polls, activities, and photos I will be posting on the community tab, which is a great way to engage with and build community. Summer will be the time for the creation of the 3D models I will be using in the bigger documentaries of the legendary prehistoric beast we all love, from Megalodon to Spinosaurus to Tyrannosaurus Rex. Video suggestions are always welcome, and we're soon going to begin integrating new topics of a very interesting array of ideas, specifically Ars Gang Yearwalk. As always, this is Enchiridion, see you next time.